Hey YouTube, Lord Alex here, and I'm going to make a video about my canteen kit, which, as you can see, actually contains two canteens. There's a lot of videos about things like this on YouTube. This is mess kit, or cooking kit, or camping kit, or a, you know, there's a lot of different things to call it. When I go out camping, I carry two canteens, and a hydration bladder. The one I have right now, I have a couple of them. The one that's attached to my camping gear is not a Camelback. It is a knockoff. But it works, and it was cheap. And there is stuff to say about cheap gear. You know, a lot of people say, oh, don't buy cheap stuff because you end up buying it again and again, and, well, that's usually true, yeah. I'm bringing to camera this pouch here. This looks like these in just about every way, except no tag here. Now, I bought all three of these on eBay. This is the first one that I bought. I didn't know any different. I was looking for, GI issue stuff. Well, I didn't realize when I bought this one, it said GI type, which is Chinese nomenclature for knockoff. You already see I'm losing threads here from double stitching. See, that's no good. But I have since bought a couple nice ones. This is the first one I bought a long time ago. It's turned into just a dump pouch because, I mean, the inside of it is starting to come apart. The snaps don't stay snapped. I actually dropped one of my canteens one time walking through the woods. So this just stays empty on the back of my butt pack. It's just a spare. Alright, now, get back to these. I'm going to go ahead and cut the video and take everything out of these things because it's kind of a pain sometimes because I have so much stuff crammed into these. And the reason I'm making this video is because I got a new addition to this kit here that I've been waiting for quite a while. I neglected in buying one a while back and then the manufacturer ran out of them. So finally got one and I'll make some videos. Alright, well, I'm going to cut the video here and bring you back here in just a second. Alright, I'm back. And this is what I have in my kits. Eventually, I'll go through my whole camping kit, which I keep in a military LBV, load-bearing vest, older, I guess, Vietnam-style, woodland camo. And I keep one of these on each side. And you'll notice as I go through that stuff, I've got multiples of things. I'm a big fan of gear. Yeah, my kit weighs about 35 pounds or so. That's with the 4 quarts of water. It's not with the hydration bladder full. Because the people that do the ultralight type stuff, I've tried that. Well, I've tried to try that, actually. And I found out that either you don't have enough stuff to be comfortable, or you're spending way too much money on the stuff that you are having. If you're going to buy the ultralight backpack and the titanium everything and the special little stoves and stuff, and I'm not big on carrying alcohol for fuel and that being that my only fuel source and things like that. So you will see through my kit, I do have multiples of different items. That's the way I like it. If you don't like it that way, that's fine. I'm not saying this is how you've got to set up your kit. This is how I have mine set up, and it works for me. Alright, so now, this is my main kit here. This is kind of my secondary kit. I do keep both of them. The main kit, it's got a Nalgene canteen. Good canteen. Not as strong as these, but It's a good canteen, and it holds less plastic flavor when you're drinking the water. So, oh, and I do prefer, with my military canteens, these are U.S. issue, you can get them with or without the clips. I prefer them with the clips, because if something were to happen, I set all my gear down, and I just want to take a canteen with me, instead of having to take one of these kits off of my gear, I just grab this, throw it over my belt, and go for a little walk, gathering firewood or whatever I'm doing. Okay, so that's my two canteens. I do carry them both full all the time. My main kit here, this is Canteen Shop stove, the grill top stove. Love this thing. This thing is awesome. It's very sturdy. I don't like that little aluminum crap that was issued for a while. It's flimsy. It gets bent out of shape, and I don't dig it. This is stainless steel, heavy duty stuff. I could use this as a shovel if I needed to dig a hole, you know, whatever. Put this down. See, it's raised up here. I mean, they put a lot of thought into these. You put a canteen cup top of that, and you have maximized your cooking fire down here. And you don't have to use just alcohol or just Esbit tabs or just wet fire or, you know, whatever you use. You can use anything. You can put wood in here, whatever, if it's the hole. All right. As you see, both of my canteens I've painted with the Rust-Oleum paint for grills and smokers, high temperature paint. I find it's easier to clean them. When you're using alcohol to cook with, it doesn't leave much residue and soot. Using just about anything else, you will black up your equipment. Like you see, this is permanently this color now. This is not pretty stainless silver anymore. I don't care. These will clean up to look like the inside, but it's a lot of work. They clean up much easier when they're black like this. Alright, now, this gets me to my newest investment here. This is the heavy cover boil cover with a strainer. This is the thing that they ran out of, I guess because it was popular. They ran out of these, and they didn't make any for another year or year and a half or so, and you couldn't find them anywhere. They're back on the market. As of September 2012, they are back on the market. So, put that on there. That's a very nice heavy-duty stainless lid there. They say you can use the bottom for signaling. Oh, you know, there I am. Ah, look at the camera. Good piece of equipment. I've been missing this. This is what my canteen kit has been missing for the last year. And now that I have it, I'm excited to test it out. And I got kind of a bonus when I ordered it. I had sent them an email a few months ago asking them when I can get one of these. And they said, well, they're coming out shortly. I don't know if they did it on purpose or it was an accident. But they sent me two. I love that. I've got two now. I'm only going to carry one, unless I feel the need. I needed to carry both of them. I might put this one in my pack also. But, yeah, they went ahead and sent me two. I ordered one, paid for one, got two. Good in my book. Alright, moving on. Got the stove. Got the canteen. Got the heavy cover lid. Boil cover. Also, this is a good heavy-duty linen napkin. Use this for cleanup afterwards. And this is the heavy cover. I'm not sure what they call this. This is the drinking lid. After you've made your coffee or your soup or whatever, take this off, because this is for in the fire. This is not so much for in the fire. This is rubber. But this will actually seal around your canteen cup. It's a little bit of work to do it, but it will seal around your canteen cup. And you can knock it over. They have videos about it. You can knock it over and it won't spill. You can tilt it up and down. You can flip it upside down and it won't spill. Open this up here and you drink from it there. It'll keep your coffee hot, keep your soup hot, and we'll keep it in there. So you don't have to worry about spilling all the soup that you just spent, you know, 15 minutes trying to get heated up and cooked correctly. I've had this one for a while, used it several times, like it a whole lot. Wish I'd bought them both at the same time. Now I have them both. I'm happy. All right. Now we come to these little guys here. These are the Guyot Designs Microbites. We've got a little spatula with a kind of a sharp edge here and a little serrated edge here. And spork. Real lightweight stuff. These are one of the things that you don't have to spend a lot of money on. They're not the highest quality, but they're good. And I do have squishy bowls also. I said a squishy cup and a squishy bowl that I keep in my camping kit, but there's not really any place to keep them in this kit here. So I keep this in the side pocket, along with a good fire steel. And I buy all my fire steels from a website called Deal Extreme. And they're from China, but they work just like the ones you buy here. I've bought ones here for two or three times as much. And these ones from China, you can get them all different sizes and shapes and lengths and girths and different handles on them and different all kinds of stuff. Very, very cheap. I'm thinking like $3 or $4 each for these guys, compared to 15 or 20 from some of your local stores around here. So that stays in there. Keep a lighter in there, just because it's easier than this. Another stove. Okay, for some reason, don't want to use this. I don't know why I wouldn't want to use this, but like I said, I like to have multiples, backups, things like that. This is an Esbit type stove. This is not an Esbit stove, but it's an Esbit type stove. I think I paid $1.50 for this thing. And my other videos about my favorite fire starter, these are these squares that I like so much. I've got them down here and inside my stove. I've got a couple of these stoves actually, but this is the one that's in my kit here. Keep extra fuel in the stove. And the actual Esbit stoves have different notches for setting. There's a notch right about there. There's a notch, you know, open it up all the way. Well, what I've noticed with the Canteen cups with this knockoff stove that doesn't work too good. Yeah, it won't sit on there properly. So get a couple of these steaks. Just regular old cheapo tin steaks. Made a couple holes in them. And ta-da! Works good for me now. Just like that. Nice and solid. Good to go. And I have another stove that's similar to this. It's not an Esbit either. I think it's a Coglins. It's a lot bigger. It won't fit in this pouch. That's why I have this particular cheapo stove in here, because it fits perfectly in this pouch right here. I don't have an actual Esbit, so I don't know if it'll fit or not. I think it's a little bit bigger than this one, so I'm guessing it would not fit either. That's why I carry the cheapo off-brand stove. And since we're talking about stoves, that's two in this kit so far. This is a military issue stove here that I've also painted. I'm not big on this one. This is meant for the liquid tabs or for what's that stuff? I got a whole box over here. Hold on a second. maybe I don't have a whole box of it. I've got some of them somewhere. They're little solid fuel tabs that were a military issue for a while until they transferred over to the gel fuel now. I like those a lot until I realized that they don't last very long. I mean, if the package, the foil package gets a hole in it, or if you use a part of it and you fold it back over, the stuff will kind of disintegrate and turn to dust. And sometimes it lights and sometimes it doesn't. So I've gotten away from that stuff. I keep this in my pack in case I need to build a small fire and for some reason there's too much wind, or I need to use some of that fuel I just showed you and it's too windy, get something going. I'll use this. Throw a piece of that those fire cubes in here. Yeah, I've got this box of those over here. Safe Light fire squares. My favorite stuff right here. Go get you some. Throw one of those down in there. And those burn for about 10 minutes. So with this boil cover, 10 minutes is more than enough time to boil whatever I need to boil in my canteen cup. Like I said, this is my backup kit. I don't use this all the time. This is kind of like a secondary one. I prefer CanteenShop.com's stove all day long. This is the best one out there. Alright. This is a cutting board. I bought them in a pack of, I think, four. And it came like, I don't know, about the size of a legal piece of paper. 8.5 by 15 or something like that. And I took my paper cutter, cut it down, and this goes in behind my canteen. Under the flap here, it stays right there in my secondary kit because both of my covers go in my primary kit. Scouring pad for cleanup. Keep this in one of the pockets. Secondary kit. Along with this. I don't dip this stuff. It's not good for you. I don't use any tobacco products anymore. But I have friends that do, and I'm constantly getting coupons for free ones. But they're handy for holding stuff. This is beef bouillon. Pretty much instant soup. Anywhere you're at, boil some water, throw one of these in there. Good soup, good hot soup. Keep you warm in the winter. Keep those in there. I used to carry this in the other pocket full of those Safe Light squares. Now I keep this in a different part of my pack. Carry this Altoids 10, which has another one of those in it. This one is full of the Safe Light squares, and I've got some cotton shoved in around it. I need to put a couple more pieces of cotton in here. Just for extra tender, just in case. And the way I pack all this stuff, see, I've got the cutting board there. Put this in there like that. And I've got canteen and the military gel fuel canteen cup and stove. And Altoids 10 on one side here. Got a scouring pad. And a small camel snus full of soup there. Canteen. That one's done. That's that kit complete. This one's a little more complicated. First, I get my rubber cover, which the reason I keep it wrapped in this linen is because it tends to attract dirt and stuff, like static or something, I'm not sure. put it in there, wrap it up, just like that. Got a little flap here, throw it in with the flap at the bottom. Same place as I put my cutting board. Then I get my heavy cover lid. I throw that down in the very bottom. And I lay that flat all the way down in there. Just like that. Then in goes other stove, canteen cup. And you already saw the Esbit type stove in here. On this side, fire steel on the one side, ferro rod or whatever you want to call it, Bic lighter here, and Giant Designs utensils over in the front. Drop in my Nalgene canteen. I will roll this up just like that. Flip over the strap. And since I got these things hanging off, I don't want them to get snagged on something and pulled out. So this one goes through the clasp like that. This one comes up underneath this toggle and back over it, like so. So there's no way that can pull out. And these, sometimes I carry them in a different part of my pack. Sometimes I will just stick them down inside, just like that. And there's my canteen kit. This video is getting to be very long, so I'm going to cut it right there. That's enough. You've seen my canteen kit, both my canteens, all my cooking gear. I can cook easily for two people, a several course meal with this right here. If it's going to be more than just me and maybe one other person, I do have a separate cooking kit that I will bring. It has a slightly bigger skillet and a pot and things like that. I'll show you that here in just a second. Alright, you guys, thanks for watching. Rate, comment, subscribe, and all that YouTube stuff. See you in the next video.